we achieved what after the independence of Bangladesh? We expected that there should be a secular state in the country. There should be a secular principle in the constitution of the People's Republic of Bangladesh. But what we see after amendment of the constitution in 1979, the then general Jiaur Rahman changed the constitution, and Bismillah Rahman Rahim has been incorporated in the constitution. Thereafter, General Ershad has come in power. He has also made Islam as a state religion in the constitution, in the 5th and 7th amendment of the constitution. So we objected as a human rights defender, as a human rights activist. We defended and we talked about it. As we have achieved independence in the year 1971 with some 4 principles: secularism, nationalism, democracy, and also Samajtantra. But all the 3 have been abrogated from the constitution. As a religious minority, we are living in a very difficult situation because of the fact that our religious temples, religious places have been destroyed, desecrated by the Muslim perpetrator. We filed many cases in the courts, but till today the justice has not yet been made by the court because of obvious reason. Till today, Sheikh Hasina is now still in power. The land grabbers belonging to the Awami League, the powerful land grabbers, they are grabbing lands belonging to the Hindu community and also Adivasi and also other communities. And as for example, we can say our minister, Muzammil Haq, he's a liberation minister nowadays in our country. He has occupied more than 45 decimals of land from Ghazipur district in Bangladesh. We approached him several times. Then he told me, Mr. Muzammil, minister, then he said, no, all are equal in the eye of law. There should not be any Muslim, there should not be any Christian, there should not be any Hindu, but all have equal rights. Then why the properties have been grabbed by your people, the Awami League people? So is it not a discrimination? And these properties have not yet been returned to the Hindu owners. Jitendra, his name is Jitendra Kumar. And still these properties under the control of this minister, Muzammil Haq. I approached several times, and ultimately we have gone to the Honorable High Commissioner of India at Dhaka, Mr. Singla. We talked about this. Mr. Muzammil Haq occupied these properties, and please try to help us. Please try to help this Jitendra Kumar to get his property back. But till today, I think 1 year is going to be lapsed. Till today, these properties have not yet been restored to Jitendra Kumar. This is the one. Then another property has been grabbed by Saber Hossain Chowdhury. He's a member of parliament at Dhaka, Dhaka city. Saber Hossain Chowdhury grabbed more than 17 acres of land belonging to one Ranjan Kumar. He's a Hindu. His properties have been grabbed, and a false case has been started against him. The case is that he's a murderer. Ranjan is a murderer. Actually, it is not a murder case. There is a concocted case filed against him, and he has been forced to come to India at West Bengal. We received the news and went there, investigated the matter locally, and saw how this Ranjam Kumar has been ousted from his home along with his family members. And we have documented under the international protocol, we have documented all these atrocities. Then I met with this Sabero Sen Choudhury, member of parliament, and told him, this is the situation, you please give up this property. Then Sabero Sen replied, Mr. Ghosh, I have not occupied this property. That property has been grabbed by some bad element. The bad element and who they are the activist of Awami League. They are the activist of Awami League. They have grabbed the property. Sabero Sen, however, Sabero Sen did not occupy the property physically, but it has been occupied by his people within his locality, within Dhaka city, within Dhaka city. And Ranjan Kumar was crying and crying with his wife. Then I came to West Bengal. I told him, don't stay here in India, don't stay here in West Bengal, you come with me at Dhaka, I will try to reoccupy the property. Then the cases has been started, and ultimately Ranjan Kumar got the case. Very good news is that Ranjan Kumar got the news that it is a false case instituted against Ranjan Kumar and his wife. But what happened? The member of parliament has not restored the property. In spite of the court's verdict, even Ranjan Kumar did not go to his place because some other people have already occupied this land. Who will take up the matter? Police is not working. Police is not working in favor of Ranjan Kumar. So this is the second. And third, one Mr. Shaun, member of parliament, he's from Bola district. He has occupied more than 17 acres of land. He is also from Awami League, the member of parliament. He is from Awami League. He's very powerful because Sheikh Hasina likes him very well. So he is very powerful. Then I went to the house of Shaun, the member of parliament, and talked with him along with the victim. His name is Sapan Kumar. The victim is Sapan Kumar. I, along with Sapan Kumar, went to the house of Mr. Shaun and requested him to give up the property. Then Shaun Kumar has become angry with me and started to rebuke in a very filthy languages. And he said, why, Mr. Ghosh, you are bothering for this, that, and that? Why, you have come for Sapan Kumar? Sapan Kumar is a bad man, sas and sas, so he should be punished. Then I told him, as you are a member of parliament, it is your responsibility to protect your voters. He is your voters. He is your citizen. So this should not be allowed to continue. Then he told me, Mr. Ghosh, don't do it in future. You don't come to my chamber in future. Don't come to my... Then he started to rebuke me in a very filthy language, and he also instigated some people at his home to beat me. Oh, Mr. Shaun, I have become... Then it was published in the newspaper also. And I have told it to the minister, home minister, our Bangladeshi home minister, the external minister. Then I told, this is the position now, your minister, your member of parliament is grabbing properties belonging to Hindus. How they will be able to stay here in Bangladesh? So provide necessary help. But till today, no help has been made to him. Then another member of parliament, there are so many, another member of parliament has occupied, I think, more than 2 and 4 acres of land belonging to Hindu community. And this is still pending because we are moving and moving in the court as well as in the High Court Division to release the property. So this is the position, not only land grabbing, there are some other discriminatory treatment against the Hindu minority in Bangladesh is going on. So we need justice. We need proper justice to restore the property. We need the temples which has been demolished recently within a 3 or 4 months should be restored to its original site and place, because it is our national pride. It is going to be finished very soon. So there are some other minority repressions which has been published many times in the newspapers and also in our news agencies, but no action has yet been taken by the government in power. So I would request through you, the media, so that the government of Bangladesh can take up the matter very urgently to stop ethnic cleansing in Bangladesh.